Hello, hello. Good day to you. You are warmly welcome back to this edition of our positive word. Open declaration. This is the focus for today's episode. Open declaration, of course. It's just saying something, proclaiming something, declaring something, speaking in public, openly, announce something. Make a statement, make pronouncements. And I'm looking at this as a child of God. We need to have open declaration of our faith, our belief in God. Because in today's world, we see a lot of people who are doing everything to conceal the fact that they're children of God, that they believe in God. When they go to certain circles, they don't want people to know that they are of God, that they know Christ Jesus. But if you really do, that would be one thing you want to share and tell everybody around you. We're told in Romans chapter 10, verse 9, if you openly declare that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Openly declare. Jesus is Lord, no doubt. Yes, the devil has brought counterfeits and would try with all kinds of silly arguments to disprove that fact, but I'm not interested in the argument. I believe the Bible, the Word of God, and I run with it. You will be saved when you declare that Jesus is Lord and you believe that he was raised from the dead. How open is your belief and faith in God? Are you one of those who try to hide? There are people you do not want to know that you are a child of God, that you believe in Jesus. So when you get in their circle, you conceal your faith. You put it on the back burner in your locket, in your locker. And you go out and live your life to please those people. Our life in Christ Jesus should be an overt operation, demonstration that He is Lord in our lives and that only He gives complete peace and contentment. They are not found in anything else, no matter what the world does. Look at where the world is today. It's gone to pieces in spite of all the advancement in so-called technology. Jesus is the only one that will give us what we're looking for. Matthew chapter 10, verse 32 and 33. Everyone who confesses me before men, I will also confess him before my Father who is in heaven. But anyone who denies me before men, I will also deny him before my Father in heaven. This is the word of God. We have to declare Jesus Christ. We have to live our lives. I'm not asking people who live in places where sharing the word of God is a taboo, is not allowed to put themselves at risk. But if you do that for Christ, hey, to live is Christ and die is gain. The life we live should be able to tell that we are of God. That is also openly declaring because we are living that life to show that we belong to Christ. No one who believes, who is a believer in Christ, can keep it secret. You can't. If it's secret, you do not know this Jesus Christ I have come to know. Your life must indicate who lives inside of you. Your open declaration lets others to see and know that there is hope and a way out of their predicament. You know, one of the reasons why many who are living in despair and rebellion are doing those against God, it's because those who should help them see the light of God are too busy trying to fit into the lifestyle and dictates of the world. My dear friend, we must declare our faith and let the world know that Jesus is Lord. The word of God is life and powerful to set people free. Let us proclaim it to the world around us. Everywhere you turn, we see decay of everything. It seems as if life has been sucked out of the earth and death is having a full-on free parade, claiming souls that rejected the love of God in salvation through Jesus Christ. Are we going to carry on pretending that it is that all is well, my friend? Are we? For how long? As we see family, friends, work colleagues, neighbors, even strangers wallowing and going deeper and deeper into life without Christ, we have to declare. If you declare with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that he was raised from the dead, you will be saved. We must confess Christ before men. We will be saved. Yes, just simply saying Jesus loves you, that's declaring. Doing the right thing when everyone else is going against policies, procedures, rules, guidelines in your workplace, you stick to what is right. That is declaring your faith in God. Nobody who comes to Jesus can live in secret. Everything you do will scream that you are a child of God. We must declare and proclaim this gospel of salvation for all to hear about Jesus Christ, who alone can save. I do not know when the Lord will return, but I know he will come soon. Are you going to continue living life as if you're in charge? You know when your day will come, when your time will be up? Let us continue to openly declare. Let us tell people about this, the coming of our Lord Jesus, because this is real and we do not want people to be lost. I thank you for joining me today. Until I come your way again, it's goodbye for now as you go on to openly declare your faith and trust in Christ Jesus. God bless you.